Our solution for parsing the Atlas definition is pretty straightforward. First, we're given Atlas JSON data that's been loaded from an XHR request. The first step that we need to do is actually go through and call JSON.parse on that. This will turn the text JSON data into an actual JavaScript object with members and values that we can iterate over. We use this to effect here. The parsed object has a frames dictionary that we'll actually iterate over to load all of our sprites. We'd like to fetch each key inside of our dictionary, and then fetch the associated sprite object that comes with it. From here, we now have the sprite name and effectively the sprite values. The next step we take here is to actually define the center of the image. So we actually multiply the width and the height times 0.5, which would give us the half width and half height. Now we store this value into CX and CY as a negative offset. The reason for this is that we'll use the CX and CY values a little later on during rendering to transform our object into proper space. We store them as negatives here so that we don't have to do the mathematics later on when we're drawing the image. Once we've got this data, we go ahead forward and call the defSprite function, passing in the image name as a key, and then the frame X, frame Y, width, height, and center data that you've already seen before.